Hello, this should be a short video as I'm just sharing a simple solution to a problem I've recently run into. In Foundry 2, initiative is more or less a resource you can spend during combat, a very called shots, and it is possible for players to spend shot when it's not their turn, an action called an interrupt. To allow for that, I've added a text field and a button on the combat tracker. This works fine when logging in as a game master, but if I log in as a player, although it seems to update the initiative correctly, there is an error message saying I'm not allowed to update the combat. If you followed this series, you might remember I needed to create a custom undo stack to keep the previous turn and previous round buttons functional. And that's where the error comes from. Even if it looks like the interrupt worked, the combat history is now broken. You see, pretty much all the code that we've written so far is in fact executed locally to each user in the session. When someone updates a document, their instance of Foundry, the client, will send an update request to the server so that it keeps everyone in sync. This is done through WebSocket connections. But some actions, such as updating a combat document, require permissions that not everyone has. Fortunately, Foundry allows us to send and receive custom socket events for our system. I won't explain this in detail, there's a page about it on the Foundry wiki, which is where most of the info for this video comes from. Besides, I'm taking the easy way out by using a third-party Foundry module called socketlib. It has a bunch of convenience methods for executing functions as another user, which is exactly what we need to do here, running the interrupt code as a GM. First of all, we need to enable socket use for our system by adding the socket property to our system.json and setting it to true. Next, we need to add a dependency to our package. So we'll add a dependencies property to which we'll add a dependency on the socketlib module. This will tell GMs that they need to have socketlib installed and enabled for the system to work. Unfortunately, it seems that modules system depend on don't automatically get enabled. So you'll have to tell your users to enable socketlib when they create a world. Next, we need to set up socketlib. I'm doing this in my main systems file, hooking onto the socketlib.ready event. In there, we'll register the system with socketlib.registerSystem, passing the name of the system as defined in the system.json file. This will return the socket instance we'll need to use everywhere, so I'm storing this in the config object. After that, we need to register a function that can be executed through sockets. It takes a name and a pointer to the function itself. I'm going to call both interrupt. Speaking of which, let's create it. It's going to take two parameters, the ID of the combat encounter and the ID of the combatant doing the interrupt. With that, we can retrieve the combat itself and call its spendShots method, passing the combatant we've retrieved from its ID. Finally, all that's left to do is call this somewhere. In the combat tracker code, in the method that is bound to the interrupt button, we used to directly call spendShots on the combat. Instead, we're now going to take our socket and call the executeAsGM method, asking to execute the interrupt function we've registered and passing the required arguments. And that's it. Now, if I connect as a player and use the interrupt button, the error has disappeared, as this change of initiative is now properly added to the undo stack, so that the GM can roll it back if necessary. Note that execute as GM only works if a user with GM permissions is currently connected to the game, otherwise it'll do nothing. It can potentially be an issue depending on your use case, but in this situation it's more of a feature than a bug. There are a few more things you can do with socketlib, but I don't have relevant examples to show, so do check the documentation for socketlib on GitHub. Many people have asked me to release the source of Foundry 2 system, and I'm happy to report that I finally opened my repository, as I needed to do so for making releases, which will be the topic of the next and probably last video. I'll put the link to the repo in the video description. Please note the system is not officially released yet, so while you may grab the manifest and install it in your Foundry instance to play, I may update the system with breaking changes without notice, so set up a campaign at your own risk. I'll see you next time. Bye.